We go to Mark Meredith. He's live at the White House. And Mark, has the White House tried to distance itself from Hunter from all of these legal issues?
Molly, good afternoon. No, not at all. In fact, we've seen the first son, Hunter Biden, make a few different appearances at the White House, both in social and formal settings over the last couple of days. Still, what you're talking about, the scandals involving the first son, could be a complication, if not a liability, for the president's reelection efforts. Republicans up on Capitol Hill, they continue to talk a lot about Hunter Biden. They are furious with the Justice Department after a plea deal was reached, which ensures Hunter will not go to jail for tax fraud. But GOP lawmakers say the deal may not be fair after two whistleblowers came forward claiming the investigation into the first son was not handled properly. Over the weekend, the U.S. attorney in Delaware told lawmakers he was not prevented from handling charges in multiple jurisdictions, and he says he will address these whistleblower complaints eventually. And while Republicans are seething mad and demanding testimony and documents, Democrats say so far they have confidence in the U.S. attorney and that they believe him when he says he was not reined in on where to charge.
But Weiss is not saying that. Isn't this the source Weiss? I mean, if Weiss was saying that, I would have a concern. If Weiss was out there saying, I didn't have total authority, there was interference. But Weiss is the key person, and he's not saying that. And there were charges that were pursued.
Meantime, the New York Times has published a deep dive on Hunter Biden's daughter in Arkansas. Hunter recently reaching a deal through child support, which means he'll turn over some of the paintings he makes, or at least the profits from them, in order to cover the four-year-old girl's expenses. But the Times wrote over the weekend, the president has not yet met or publicly mentioned his other grandchild. His White House has not answered questions about whether he will publicly acknowledge her now that the child support case is settled. Now, the White House traditionally does not answer questions when it comes to the first family. They once again say that Hunter Biden is a private citizen. But Republicans, of course, continuing to say that they are going to investigate not only happened with past business dealings and with the Biden family, but obviously what's happened with the Justice Department in this case. So it's an issue, Molly, that's not going to be going away anytime soon.
Absolutely. You covered a lot of ground for us there, Mark Meredith. It was fascinating to see just how far the New York Times went with that report as well. But thank you so much for your reporting. Mark, have a wonderful 4th of July.
Thank you. You too.
Let's bring in Charlie Hurt, Washington Times opinion editor and a Fox News contributor. Charlie, thanks for being here. Let's just start off with, where do we go from here?
You heard
Congressman Ro Khanna say, look, I'm going to take David Weiss's word on this. Yeah. He says he had the authority to pursue the charges and to the extent, the full authority. But at the same time, though, in that same statement from David Weiss, Charlie, he also said that he was geographically limited as to where he could charge Hunter
exactly
for those taxes. So I'm wondering, you know, you're Republicans, you want to, I imagine he's going to be the first person you want to speak to.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And I think that that a lot more about this is going to come out, if for no other reason, because of that statement. That statement made absolutely no sense. The very meat of the pressure that people suspect was born by Weiss is the fact that he was geographically limited. So when he says that I had free rein and ultimate authority to press charges any way I wanted, any place I wanted, but I was geographically limited, is kind of like saying yes, no, or I'm not guilty, but I'm guilty. There is no doubt that Hunter Biden got unbelievable cover. And by the way, the entire Biden family, this is not just about Hunter Biden. The entire Biden family, because of the, you know, so many of the questions that we're talking about here do extend beyond just Hunter Biden. There's no question that he was being covered by DOJ officials in the District of Columbia and in the state of California. And Weiss's statement, even as he says, oh, no, I had a free rein, admits that.
Let's go to this is from Miranda Devine. She writes in the New York Post. It's an op-ed headline, blowing the lid off the cover-up of Hunter Biden's costly plea deal. And she writes this, now comes the messy business of covering up the cover-up. Either Weiss lied to his team on October 7th or Garland lied to Congress. That is Merrick Garland, the attorney general. Garland, under oath on March 1st, told Congress that Weiss has full authority to bring cases in other districts if he needs to do that. Weiss, in a letter to Congress on June 7th, backed Garland, saying he had been granted the ultimate authority over this matter, including responsibility for deciding where, when, and whether to file charges. Note, he did not say full authority. What Miranda's getting at here is, do you think this is going to extend to Merrick Garland? And she's also pointing to the fact that there seems to be a lot of legalese here as to ultimate authority, full authority, that, you know, probably needs to be answered at some point, somewhere.
Absolutely, Brian. And there's no doubt that they're playing sort of word games here. And by the way, Weiss is playing these word games, which is sort of extremely concerning, because obviously you would like to think that Weiss is trying to pursue the truth here. And when you start playing word games about something like this, you start to think, okay, maybe you're not trying to pursue the truth. Maybe you're trying to cover things up. But all of this, of course, comes with the backdrop of Hunter Biden's ex-business partner, Devin Archer, apparently is going to be testifying before a congressional committee. You've got two committees, the Judiciary Committee and the House Oversight Committee, looking into this. And there's no doubt that they're going to get closer and closer, even with the groundwork that has been laid by the IRS whistleblowers, who have raised additional very disturbing questions about whether Merrick Garland, Weiss, and others have been telling the truth. I suspect that this is not going to go away anytime soon.
Yeah, I mean, certainly there's a lot of smoke there. We'll keep following it. At this point, I want to switch over to the Supreme Court decisions. Democrats are coming out and saying essentially that this is dangerous, that the three decisions this past week by the conservatives.
Please join the conversation. Put your comments and suggestions below in the comment section. Thank you for subscribing to this news channel. You will be notified of any breaking news and new post as you become part and parcel of the MACAD TV family. Please like and share MACAD TV. We love you all. Please support MACAD TV Foundation by joining membership and visiting Amazon UK to purchase the displayed books to aid our orphanage projects across Africa.